another zombie movie. But of course, as is the trend as of late, this time with a twist. Blood Quantum is a zombie movie that takes place on an Indian reservation called Red Crow. And we come to find that apparently Native Americans are immune to the zombie virus, or at least the ones in the Red Crow reservation are. The vast majority of the zombies are coming from the neighboring town that's not part of the reservation. White people are the ones that are contracting the virus and invading onto the Native Americans' land, and the Native Americans have to fight for said land. I think there's a message here. Despite all of this movie's underlying messages and themes, the story is fairly simple. The zombies are coming and we need to survive. This one does take a little bit of time to get going, and the first 20 minutes is a bit rocky. But when it takes off, it really fucking takes off and is a really good time. The first 20 minutes isn't necessarily bad, but I can't go as far as to say it's good either. It consists mostly of some attempts at character building and just showing you how this world works and everything that's going on. And while I do appreciate that, the execution of that character building is lacking a little bit. I can't really say that I wanted there to be more character building, I just wish there was better character building. The movie does take some time to build a few of its central characters up, but it's just not done very well. You get a little bit of an idea of what's going on with these main characters, but it's just kind of shaky. But like I said, around about the 20 minute mark, things ramp up markedly and just take the fuck off. And at that point, this movie becomes pretty fucking awesome. While none of the characters here are particularly interesting, I will say that the most interesting arc of these characters would be the one with one of the characters and his girlfriend who's pregnant. You see, he's Native American and his girlfriend is white, and she's pregnant, and since she's really susceptible to the disease, they don't really know what's gonna happen with her. There's this constant fear that she's gonna turn, and what's that gonna do to their baby that's inside of her? There's also the question of, when this baby's born, what is it gonna be? They don't really know. This is the beginning of this bad situation, and they've seen some really bad shit happen. So they are worried that at any given time, this kid could start eating her from the inside out. While the movie does have some interesting parts to it, I will say that that arc was the most interesting and most engaging in the whole entire movie. Something else the movie does really well is tension. They build tension very well in this movie and keep it constant throughout. One of the key ways that they do this is that they show you fairly early on that nobody in this movie is safe. There's characters you're introduced to that just by watching movies for years and years, you know, oh yeah, they're gonna make it to the end, or at least close to the end. They'll be safe. Nope. Nobody's safe here. Anybody could be off at any minute, and when they are, it is in gloriously gory fashion. Which leads me to one of the most entertaining things about this movie. It is fucking gory as hell. It borderlines on ridiculously gory at times. Never quite gets there. It stays more or less realistic, but god damn, there's a lot of blood, guts, and dismemberment in this fucking movie. And it all looks really fucking good. The practical effects in this movie, which a lot are, look fantastic. And there is a fair amount of CG in the movie too. It's nothing too crazy. Most of it is used to make other practical things look better, which is the best way to use CGI. But even though there is a fair amount here, it all looks really good too. Save for about one or two moments, none of it's bad. And even those two moments, they're not bad, they're just less than everything else. Overall, effects-wise, practical and CGI, they did a really good job with this movie. And if you like gore, you're really gonna like this movie, because there's a shit ton of it. Performances overall are pretty good. There's a couple of stiff moments here or there, but nothing that ruins the experience by any means. Overall, everybody does a really good job, and I would say for this genre of film, actually the performances are probably a step above what you typically get. Nobody in particular really stands out, however, everybody here does a fairly solid job. I think by this point, we're kinda used to zombie movies sometimes having depressing endings. But holy shit, this one has a really depressing ending. I mean, I guess there's some happiness to be found in it all, but it is amongst a shit ton of bad things. And that little bit of happiness aside, just be prepared that this ending is a downer. Guys, I really enjoyed this movie. Now, you gotta get past that first 15 or 20 minutes, which they're not terrible, but you do have to get past it. They're a little bit of a slog. But once past that, this movie is awesome and a really good time. It has some solid performances, some great special effects, and when the zombie action is on, it is fucking on. And if gore is your thing, you will be pleased here. There's even a message here if you're into that. Overall, Blood Quantum was really fun and I had a great time with it and think it is absolutely worth streaming. If you can get past that first 15 or 20 minutes, I think this is a great movie that you'll all have a really good time with. So there it is, guys, my review of Blood Quantum. If you enjoyed and want more content like this, hit that subscribe button and help my little channel grow. If you liked what I had to say, give me a thumbs up. If not, let me know in the comments below why. And as always, stay sexy, Red Crow.
Who says we're immune?
Okay, this is like the third movie in just a couple of weeks that I've watched where a zombie or supernatural zombie-ish character has ripped off somebody's dick and then proceeded to eat it. I mean, what the fuck's going on? When did this become a trend? I don't like it.